Welcome. This is a production of the St. Kitts and Nevis Inland Revenue Department to explain the requirements for filing and payment of unincorporated business tax, commonly known as UBT. This tax is levied at the rate of 4% from the sale of goods or services rendered after granted exemption. It applies to every person or group of persons conducting business in the Federation of St. Kitts and Nevis who is not registered under the Companies Act. This tells the IRD about your business's income and at the same time allows you to be eligible for tax concessions or relief. It is important for taxpayers to familiarize themselves with the details on the remittance form in order to complete it accurately. The following information is systematically generated and must not be altered by the taxpayer. They are the taxpayer's legal name, the name of the business, and the business's address. The document number is a unique number generated for all remittance forms, which can only be processed once. Date issued, the day on which the remittance form was generated and sent out to the taxpayer. The date due, the day on which the remittance form is expected to be returned to the IRD. The tax account number, a unique number allocated to each taxpayer. The tax period, the indicated year for which the remittance form is produced. And the assessment period date. This states a specific filing time frame. In this example, Jane Doe is the taxpayer and Groceries Galore is the name of her business. In this demonstration, she's engaged in the sale of goods and is rendering delivery services and has one establishment. It is assumed that Jane Doe's assessment period, which is filed quarterly for UBT, is June 1st to August 31st. Hence, filing and or payment is due on September 15th for Groceries Galore. From the good record keeping she has done, all information regarding sales transactions for the reporting period would be gathered. When all sales have been totaled, the total revenue received for goods before any deductions or allowances should be recorded on 9/10. Gross revenue from sale of goods, which is in this case $60,000. When all sales from the rendering of services have been totaled, the revenue received should be recorded on 9/20. Gross revenue from services rendered, which in this case is $40,000. Each taxpayer is allowed an exemption amount, which is a set total that reduces their taxable revenue. The exemption amount for the sale of goods is $37,500 and $6,000 for services rendered on a quarterly basis. This should be recorded on 9/11 and or 21 respectively. It is important to note that each taxpayer is allowed one exemption amount. For example, if the business has two retail establishments, the exemption amount of $37,500 is divided between both establishments. The taxable total is then calculated by subtracting the exemption amount from the gross revenue of goods and services reported on line 12 and 22 respectively. Line 12 should total $22,500 and line 22 should total $34,000. The total taxable revenue of $56,500 is then reported on line 30, gross taxable revenue. In this case, where the business is engaged in both sale of goods and the rendering of services, the amount reported on line 12 and 22 should be added to determine the total gross taxable revenue. The total tax due is then calculated by multiplying the amount reported on line 30 by 4%. Line 40 should then report $2,260. If the amounts reported on line 10 or 20 are below the exemption amount, the taxpayer should report nil on line 13. If no amount is reported on line 30, the tax due is nil. After all the relevant lines have been filled, you must sign the general declaration, which states, I certify that the information on this return is correct, complete, and fully discloses my liabilities for the related tax. The date on which the remittance form was completed, the signature, and the title of the individual who completed the remittance form must be recorded. If any of the aforementioned is omitted, your remittance form will be deemed incomplete and will not be processed by the IRD. This must be done on or before the specified due date to avoid the automatic imposition of a $100 late filing penalty per month, a 10% payment penalty on the outstanding tax, and interest at the rate of 1% per month on the outstanding tax. For further information regarding filing and payment of unincorporated business tax, visit the Unincorporated Business Tax Act No. 5 of 2010 on our website, sknird.com, or contact the Inland Revenue Department at 465-8485. Inland Revenue Department, building our nation through responsible tax administration.